Hey everybody, it is your girl here, Jamie Lee Divine, and today we're going to be talking about love compatibility, Leo woman with Capricorn man. This is actually a highly requested video. In all actuality, Leos and Capricorns are extremely attracted to each other. But as I say in all of my videos, when it's pertaining to love compatibilities, it takes a lot more than just the sun sign to actually get an accurate compatibility reading. Actually, what we do in astrology is we do a synastry chart where we combine both charts together, Leo woman with Capricorn man, to see how you guys fall into one another's houses and what type of aspects you guys create together. And that will give us a more accurate accountability of what can possibly happen in your relationship. The sun sign offers really good information, but it's not the whole story. So in my video, anything that you do not resonate with, it's okay. It means that it's something else going on in your chart, which is totally expected. Whenever I think of Leo and Capricorn together, Leo woman brings sun energy. This is fire energy. Then you have Capricorn bring in earth energy. This is very structured type energy. Leo is very warm, friendly, and loving and kind, very youthful. Both of these planets, the Sun and Saturn, they both reign in authority. You have the Sun, which is the ultimate authority in the sky because every planet revolves around the Sun. You have Saturn that is old, mature, structured, wise, kind of like a father figure to a certain extent. So Saturn has its authority as well. So you have old authority with young authority. Capricorn representing the older authority and Leo with the younger authority. Now, do I feel like Saturn and the Sun are the best of friends in the sky? Not necessarily. I feel like there's a little bit of awkwardness between the two, but nonetheless, they do work well together in all actuality. I feel like in this compatibility, Leo Sun, Capricorn Saturn, they can actually be really good together when it comes to financial structure. You know, building that type of foundation for their family dynamic, I feel like they can be powerful. They can be wonderful together. This is one of those couples that you could look at as being a power couple. Leo woman is always getting this attention. She's naturally rules the fifth house of dating and entertainment. So she could be the type of person who always have a side gig, bringing in multiple incomes. You have Capricorn over here. He's so responsible. He's structured and he believes in taking care of his family. Capricorn is polar opposite to Cancer. So Capricorn man can be extremely domineering in a relationship to a certain extent. He can also be extremely structured. He can be extremely status oriented. He's very classy in that way where he want people to look at him and know that he has achieved something in his life. Leo woman being the natural attention getter, she's naturally flamboyant. You know, she's naturally innovating things because Leo is polar opposite to Aquarius, which means Aquarius lies deep within Leo. She's very conventional, unconventional, where she can live outside of the box. So whatever Capricorn man, his cardinal energy, whatever he initiates and bring to the table, Leo is willing and ready to accommodate. Because what happens, the difference between a Leo woman and a Leo man is a Leo woman, she takes her sun and gives it to her lover. And he, at that moment, becomes her sun. And she revolves around him. So whatever Capricorn man brings to the table, Leo woman is ready to oblige, and this is how their compatibility can actually work. Now, is it going to be the best relationship? Not necessarily, because of the simple fact that Leo is conforming willingly, but at the same token, she still is gonna feel like she's missing something, because Leo woman, this is fire energy. This is passion. But you have earth and you have structure here that lacks passion. So it's very, very difficult when they come together to try and make that passion come, that bond that you want, that bond that you see on TV when you're watching Hallmark movies. It's very difficult for them to feel like they really have that. Leo wants that. Capricorn is very practical and logical. It's no big deal. He's thinking in his head, I'm here, we're together, we have this, we're doing this, what more do you want? Leo woman is like, I need something more. I don't know exactly what it is. Yes, I have a great life with you. We have all these things. Our life is beautiful, but something's missing. I see this all the time, mainly because Leo falls into the eighth house of Capricorn. So Capricorn man is extremely attracted to Leo, you know, her being so, you know, well put together, so sexy, you know, so warm and so friendly, so full of life. So opposites do attract. So I see a lot of these couples who are married, and it's mainly because they've made it through that phase and they've made it over to the eighth house type activities, things behind closed doors. This is when they're actually coming together to merge, to become one. And this is what is so spectacular about these two, is that they can come together, they can merge, and they can become one of those couples that people love to see and adore. And they have a lot of great times together, but at the same token, it's just when it comes to the connection, the strong bonding, the strong connection. When Leo woman wants to feel that she's reciprocating back the same passion that she's giving to her Capricorn man, but sometimes she can feel like that's not coming through. Capricorn man feels like Leo is a little bit too needy when it comes to passion, and carry on a little bit too much like a child when it comes to sex. And I feel like because the two of them, they kind of like have these different ways of thinking and operating in life to a certain extent, that it causes a conflict for them. But I don't think the conflict is so strong that it causes them to lose what they have. But I have seen a lot of Leo and Capricorns go their separate ways because of the simple fact it was just a little bit too much to take. Now, as I said in the beginning of the video, you definitely need to have a synastry chart done so you can see where you're compatible in other areas, not just the sun signs, because originally the sun signs alone are not compatible. But when you put everything together, then that's when you'll be able to see where you guys actually, you know, come together and become your greatest, you know, become the best at being in this relationship. Because I've seen a lot of these type compatibilities work, and I've also seen a lot of them fail. But it's about what you're willing to give and what you're willing to give up in order to make this compatibility work for you. Leo woman, if you're willing to give up, you know, having those feelings of bonding with someone, or that feeling of passion with someone that you crave for, that attention that you crave for from your mate, then Capricorn man is that guy for you. You guys hold on to it and you continue to make it work. Capricorn man, if you want to give up that logical and practical ways so that you can kind of like have a little bit more fun, be a little bit more willing to cuddle more and kiss more and just do all of those intimate things more, then Leo woman is definitely the woman for you. She wants to be cuddled, she wants to be loved, she wants to be admired by you. That's important for her. Leo woman, your Capricorn man wants to be respected. He wants to be respected as the authority in the relationship. He wants to have his alone time. That's important for Capricorn men, because they don't want to hear a lot about their work and that is coming between the two of you. Because remember, Capricorn men is all about practicality, and he's very logical, and he feels like if this is what he does, he loves to work, he's bringing in income, he's making sure that you guys are taken care of, he shouldn't have to hear a lot about it. I feel like Capricorn men, sometimes they can go through very difficult times in their life. Having that Saturn influence, they go through a lot of ups and downs. They meet a lot of obstacles in their life. So they tend to really be focused on work, because work is what keeps them sane. Work is what makes them feel like they're climbing. Their symbol is the goat, and the goat is there for a reason. Capricorns like to climb. They like growth. They like consistency. And that's important for Capricorn men. Leos, on the other hand, they have more of a youthful expression when it comes to life. You have Leo, who's so full of optimism and can see the good in almost any situation. But then you have Capricorn man, who is more of a pessimistic type person, who can always see the negatives in every situation. And that's mainly because he has been through so many challenges throughout his life, has faced so many obstacles throughout his life, starting from childhood. Leo, on the other hand, has always been the one that stood out in the crowd, probably was popular in school, if not, you know, had a lot of great things going for her, and never really had to run into a lot of problems that she couldn't get out of, you know, easily to a certain extent. Capricorns have to work hard, and you both have to have that understanding, and you have to draw a common ground, and from there, that's where the two of you guys will be able to make your relationship work. Because understanding one another, where you're coming from, and what you have to genuinely offer naturally is what's going to help you guys remain in a really good relationship that will last a lifetime. I've seen these compatibilities last forever, where they don't break, and mysteriously, you go through a lot, but somehow you guys tend to hold it together. And that's just that gravitational pull that you guys have towards one another. Now, when it comes to raising a family, I see you guys being wonderful parents, because you have Capricorn energy that is going to be structured and the authority figure, and he's going to be a good father. Capricorns like to take care of their families. They have Cancer buried within them, so they're family-oriented type people. And you have Leo, who's warm, kind, and friendly, and love children, where the kids can have this fun energy. And both of them work, and they both like to have nice things. They like to look good when they go out. Status is of the ultimate best, is at the ultimate importance for these two. And so their kids are gonna always have nice things, and they're gonna always be very well taken care of and nurtured at the same time. So I do see so many great positive aspects for this compatibility. But when it comes to the question, is it a match made in heaven, or is it a match that heaven somehow rejected? It is a match that is never ever going to give up. So with that being said, you guys, that's all I have. Until the next time, I wish you guys so much love, peace, and so many wonderful blessings. Bye.